Welcome back. We'll continue on the ROV project. We have it planned, purchased, and last time we programmed it. Now we're going to leave the lab and go ahead and build out the frame.
So here's what I'm thinking for the ROV body. We'll go with a zero turn design, so we'll have four motors mounted for up and down motion, as well as turning left and right, and then forward and backwards. We'll kind of have the prototype ROV thruster already made with two blades here. I also tried printing on the SLA 3D printer to see how that works. And all the electronics will go inside.
So here's what I'm thinking so far for the ROV thruster mount. It'll go ahead and hold both motors. We'll have the one that's for up and down, kind of placed here in the center of the arm. And then for forwards and backwards, that'll be in line with the rest of the body. We will be extensively 3D printing a lot of the parts for this project, but that doesn't mean you still can't do the exact same thing at home with wood, PVC, hot glue. The limits are endless. The 3D printer just happened to be a convenient tool for us here right now.
This is what we do when we wait for the 3D printer. I bet you thought we wrote code or something important.
So here's the finished 3D print for the motor mounts. The only issue I have with it right now is the PVC is just a little too big for the tolerance of the printer, so we're going to take it to the lathe and see if we can shrink that down a tiny bit.
We need some way of guaranteeing that we can still get inside and service our electronics while keeping water out. So for that matter, I think that we're going to end up just making one opening for this entire system, and that'll be right here through this hatch. We just need to figure out a way to seal that in. And at the same time, I'd like some way for the electronics to be able to slide in and out on like a big serviceable rack that we can just put right back in, put our top back on, and keep going.
Okay, looks like the spacers that we 3D printed fit it pretty good for that carriage system with just the right amount of tolerance. Let's go ahead and see if we can get that assembled.
So I'm going to be using these old carbon fiber arrows as part of the structure for the rack for the electronics.
So here's what I'm thinking so far. We're going to mount all the electronics on these two white panels here. Two carbon fiber shafts to serve as reinforcement. Put this guy in the middle. Kind of like a stabilizer. More or less, this is what I was thinking as far as the carriage goes, and all the electronics will go on there. Camera on the front, and all the cables will come through the back.
So here's the frame post glue. Looks like we have a bit of cleaning to do on it, but other than that, not too shabby.